we have the Lilavati of Bhaskaracharya, a popular text in on Indian mathematics, which has attracted a number of commentaries, which the fact itself attests that it has been studied by many, and that attests that this was used to introduce Indian mathematics in schools and for centuries. Some of the Sanskrit commentaries available are, I have listed six of them. Ganitamrita Lahari, which one is oldest one, of Ramakrishna, Ganitamrita Sagari of Gangadhara, Ganitamrita Kupika of Suryadasa, Buddhivilasini of Ganesha Devajna, Kriyakramakari of Shankara and Narayana, and Nisrstarthaduti of Munisvara. Later also many commentaries were composed. And among these commentaries, the Nisrstarthaduti, which literally can be translated as the emissary of the bestowed meaning, is a brilliant and yet unpublished one. The author of this commentary, Munisvara, was in the 17th century, the son of Ranganatha. Ranganatha is a famous mathematician, who astronomer mathematician, who is the author of Gudhartha Prakashika, a commentary on Surya Siddhanta, and he was a resident of Varanasi. Munisvara was also known as Vishwarupa, and he is known to have composed many other texts also. Siddhanta Sarvabhauma, Siddhanta text on astronomy, and an auto commentary on that, Swashaya Prakashini, and Marichi Vyakhya, a commentary on Siddhanta Shiromani of Bhaskaracharya, and Patisara is a text on arithmetics. In his commentary itself, this Nisrstarthaduti is praised like this: Ayam Lilavatyah patudurabhagahoti gahano manobhavo bhuyans tadadhigatayeyam vyarachayat munishastametam kritimakritidushprapya vishayam nisrishtartham dutim iva bhajata bhavena chaturah. So this is a beautiful verse having poetic flourish called Shleshalankara. Here he explains what this commentary how this commentary is actually. The Lilavati is having a deep meaning, and to make it understandable to the people, so he is composing this commentary, which is named as Nisrstarthaduti. So this word Nisrishta has several meanings. One of them is deep meaning, and Nisrstarthaduti is a kind of messenger described in literal works, literary works. One kind of a messenger who tries to accomplish the union between maiden and the youth by giving the apart from giving the message, he tries to address the doubts which may arise in the mind of the receiver. So this name is very apt for this commentary. So as it really addresses the doubts which may arise in the mind of the readers, and he says this is akriti dushprapya vishayam. This cannot be attained, can be available for meritorious people. So only kriti, the meritorious people can access this. So Pandit Sudhakar Dwivedi also pays a glorious tribute to the Nisrstarthaduti by saying this. He describes this text as Uttamottama, Uttamottama Lilavati Tika. Lilavati Tika cha samprati sarvatra bharata varshe anya tikatah uttamottameti jyotirvidhrim mata. He describes it as best among the excellent. So the merits of the Lilavati can be understood when we read that. Anyone who reads this commentary cannot but agree that this emissary not only conveys the intended message but adds more value in a number of ways. Here Munisvara presents many discussions by way of providing demonstrations and proof along with those provided by other mathematicians. He quotes eminent mathematicians like Aryabhata, Brahmagupta, Sripati, second Aryabhata, etc. And he also throws light on lesser known scholars like Lakshmi Dasa, Ramachandra, Surya Daivajna, Balakrishna, Vishnu Daivajna, Keshava Daivajna, etc. Apart from giving the derivations given by them, as a well-versed critic, he accepts those derivations or rejects them wherever it is appropriate. We can see some of the examples. So apart from the names of eminent scholars like Aryabhata, we find other names like which I have listed here of various mathematicians. Narayana, we find these names in his commentary. Narayana is, we cannot say he is very less known. He is the author of Ganita Kaumudi, and here we have a confusion about the Narayana mentioned here. I have put his name in the first. Another Narayana is also mentioned there. So Narayana is the son of Narasimha, who was in the 14th century. And he is the author of famous Ganita Kaumudi, and he wrote a commentary on Bijaganita also, which is named as Bijaganita Avatamsa. And we find the name of Keshava Daivajna, son of Kamalakara, and Lakshmi Dasa, son of Vachaspati, Surya Dasa, son of Jnanaraja, Vishnu Daivajna, Divakara's son, Krishna Daivajna, son of Ballala, and Narayana, one who is the teacher of Munisvara. He is very less known, son of Govinda, and Ramachandra. We find the mention that he is mentioned as the student of Krishna Daivajna, and not much known about him. And Balakrishna, actually, we could not find who he is. Yes, he is the composer of Jataka Paddhati. Yes. And in several instances, we find this name, Lakshmi Dasa, quoted by Munisvara. He is son of Vachaspati and grandson of Keshava. In Ganakatarangini of Pandit Sudhakar Dwivedi, we find that he is also called as Lakshminatha. And we came to know that he had written a commentary on Lilavati, which is named Siddhanta Shiromani, Ganita, which is named as Ganita Tattva Chintamani. And he has also authored a commentary on Lilavati, but the name is unknown. And it is stated that upapattis stated by him are, he has stated it in an arithmetic way. Vyaktaritya upapattihi. This is what Sudhakar Dwivedi says about him. And discussion on combinatorics we find in Lilavati. So in this context, we find proof of Lakshmi Dasa in the text of Munisvara. Actually, this verse says that ekadyekottara anka vyasta bhajyah kramasthitaihi parapurvena sangunyas tatparas tatparena cha ekadvitriyadi bhedah syuridam sadharanam smritam. This gives the rule for finding out the number of combinations or varieties of combinations we can have with n entities when they are chosen in r selected ways. So when we decode the verse, we get this formula. Ekadi ekotra ankaha, so the numbers increasing by 1 till n are placed reversely, and we place the numbers in the order in the denominator, and as required we multiply and divide them. Here Munisvara explains how the formula is derived. So actually after explaining this, the approach, he leads it to the verse of Lakshmidasa. So let us see how he has explained the formula given by Lakshmidasa. So here we have six terms, T1 to T6. So this is discussed in the context of different tastes when they are combined with the selection of 1, 2, etc. So we have several dishes. So how many dishes we can obtain by combining the taste 1, taste 2, etc. So this can be taken to any other terms also. So with the if we have combination 1, means only one taste, one tea we take, then we can have n different ways. So here in the case of this, we have six ways of having selected one, we can have six dishes. So it is called as sankhyamitaha. So that n is same as n by 1. And when we want to combine two things, and if we want to calculate number of varieties we obtain, so we get the number of combinations equal to the summation of n minus 1 entities. So that is stated as ekona sankalitam. So this, when we apply the formula of sankalita and we calculate it, we get n minus 1 into n into n divided by 2. This is summation of n minus 1 terms. And if we want to combine three entities, and if we want to calculate the varieties of them, then we have to calculate dvina sankalita, sankalitaikya, sum of summations of n minus 2 terms. The notationally it can be expressed like this. And if we go one more step further to count the number of varieties having the combinations of four entities, then we must calculate triuna sankalita ikyaikyam. So there is sum of summations of n minus 3 terms. And similarly, if we choose 5, then it is chaturuna sankalita ikyaikyaikyam. So sum of summations of n minus 4. And similarly, one step further with n minus 5 terms. So this is beautifully explained in this prose. He says, ekavyakti bhedah sankhyamitah bhedasyapi swatah jnanat sankhyaika bhaktayityuktam bhajanoktyanugamanartham. So we have n possible ways of combinations having one, that is n, which can be taken as n by 1. So when we compute varieties of combinations of two, dvivyakti bhedah ekona sankhyayah shredhi vyavaharoktam sankalitam. Actually, this discussion on this comes before he explains the shredhi vyavahara. So that will be explained in the next chapter. But here he explains this here itself. How sankalita can be applied here. Yathahi prathamena dvyadibhi pratyekamiti dvabhyam bhedah ekona sankhyamitah. Having taken T1 and keeping the first entity intact, so if we want to combine other tests with the first one, then we have n minus 1 ways of getting combinations. And similarly, if we take second entity and if you want to combine the others, then n minus 3 ways we can obtain. And if we take the third entity and if we combine the others with that, so we have n minus 3 possibilities. Similarly, we go up to 1. So this is summation of n minus 1 terms. So when we apply the summation rule, we get the summation as this. So n minus 1 into n by 2. So he says, ataha purvena sangunyaha dvibhaktaha paraha purvena sangunyaha dvibhaktaha ityupapannam. Then he explains the combinations of three. Vyakti trayabhedaha dyuna sankhyayaha sankalitaikyam. Yathahi tisrubhihi vyaktivihi bhedastu prathamadvayena triyadibhihi saha dyuna sankhyamitaha bhedaha. So when we have the combination of three entities, so we can take first two constant and we can combine other testers with the first two in n minus 2 ways. And if we want to combine keeping first intact, and if you want to combine three with that and other testers with that, then we have n minus 3 combinations. So the with respect to the first entity, we have the summation of n minus 2 terms, and with respect to second one, we have n minus 3 summation of n minus 3. So he says prathama tritiyabhyam chaturadibhi triuna sankhyamitaha. So this is with first and three. So we take first and three as intact and we combine other testers with that. And first and fourth, we have panchamadibhi chaturuna sankhyakaha. So we get it like this. So in this way, if we combine all these, then we have the sum of summations. So similarly, dvitiya vyakti sambandhat vyaktitraya bhedaha triuna sankhya sankalitam, evam tritiya sambandhat chaturuna sankhya sankalitam, chaturadi sambandhat panchadyuna sankhya sankalitani. So in this way, dyuna sankhya sankalitaikyam vyaktitraya bhedaha. Sum of summations of this will give the varieties of combinations with three entities. So then further he says, how to get this? By simply multiplying by n by 3. The sankalita of n minus 2 terms multiplied by n and divided by 3. So then we have terms like n, n minus 1 and n minus 2. And in the denominator we have 1, 2 and 3. He says purva bheda gunita paranka rupa dyuna sankhyaya stratiyamsha iti paraha purvena sangunya stribhakta ityupapandam. So this is actually the number of varieties of combinations with 2, and if we multiply it by n and divide by 3, then we get the combinations of 3. Similarly, he explains chaturvyakti bhedaha. So here we take in the first step we take t1, t2, t3 and we combine with the others, and we get summation of n minus 3 terms. So atha chaturvyakti bhedaha triuna sankhyayah sankalitaikyam tadyatha prathamadibhihi tribhihi chaturadibhihi triuna sankhya bhedaha. Then he takes prathama tritiyabhyam chaturvyaktya cha panchadibhi chaturuna sankhya bhedaha. We have to take first, third and fourth entities and we try to combine with others, then summation of n minus 4 terms, and similarly we have to continue it like this. Thus with respect to t1, we get the sum of sums of n minus 3 terms. that is stated as evam prathama sambandha triuna sankhyayah sankalitam. The next step is to take T2, T3 and T4 and we combine them with the others. So then we get summation of n minus 4 terms and T2, T4, T5 are combined with the others. So we get summation of n minus 5 terms. Thus with respect to T2, we get the sum of n minus 4. Similarly, with respect to T3, etc., we get the sum of sums of n minus 5 and so on. So thus, the sum of summations of n minus 3 terms is proved to be the number of varieties of combinations of four entities. Tasma chaturvyakti bhedah triuna sankhyayah sankalita ikyaikyam siddham. Tattu sa dvyutenetyadiritya avagata sankalita ikyaikya prakarena sankalita ikyam triyuta padagunitam chaturbhaktam ityadi ityatmakena. It should be here n by 4 actually. So after saying this, Munishwara quotes Lakshmidasa's verse. Ekadi yutagachagdam dvyadibhaktam padam kramat phalani syuh sankalita tadaikyadini tanitu. Ekadyuttara gachhanam dvitryadi guravo bhida. Here the word gachha refers to indicates the number of terms, n. And he says gachha shabdena padam, pada shabdena swabhimitam gachha sankalita ikyam. By the word pada we should take summation. So and the word phalani indicates the successive results we get. Phalani kramene ekottaranam gachhanam sankalita tadaikyadini syuhu. Tani sankalitadini dvitryadi guravo bhedah. This will be giving a number of combinations having 1, 2, etc. Guru characters. So, yatha yogyamiti vyakhyanena sangachyate. So, actually he has explained this in the previous prose. And in the same context, he explains Prastara. Actually, he quotes Ramachandra. And the Prastara, we should understand it as the enumeration rule for generating all the possible metrical patterns of a given class as a sequence of rows. So here we can see that this curved line indicates guru, the syllables which has two beats, and the straight line indicates laghu. Put prastara for if you want to have a meter for the prastara for four syllabled group, then we have 16 varieties. So here we can see all gurus and one laghu, three gurus. In similarly, we have 16 varieties. So how do we, here we can see all gurus have one occurrence and one guru has four occurrences. So how do we compute this? Without putting the prastara, without calculating it manually, how can we calculate it using the formula? So here Munishwara quotes Ramachandra, a student of Krishnadevajna. So if we, in the among four syllables, if we take one guru and three laghus, so we can have four different ways of putting one guru. So here, so we can see all the prastaras occur once. So we have four varieties. So he simply says this is 4 by 1. So in the next step, we will understand this. So the prastaras with two gurus can be obtained by replacing one more laghu. So in the prastaras of one guru, if we replace one laghu with guru, so then we get the different pattern. So this is same as this, the with one guru. Now, so in the first line, we can have three different ways of putting one more guru. So in three places, so whichever place we can take. Here also we have three places, and in three different ways we can put one more guru. So similarly, 3, 3, 3, 3. So now we see the repetition of the pattern. So if we closely observe, the same pattern occurs twice. So the total number of prastaras we got by replacing one more laghu, we got 12 varieties. Then, so since the same variety occurs twice, you simply divide it by 2. So hence divided by 2, then we get actually 12 by 2, which can be written as 4 into 3 by 1 into 2. So this is actually n into n minus 1 divided by 1 into 2. So this is actually which can be obtained using the rule stated by Bhaskar also. So now we have 6 varieties of having 2 gurus. Now we want to move it to the third step. So having 3 gurus in each group. So we try to replace one more laghu. So we can in two ways we can replace it. So so we get again this. Then we something is wrong here. So since the prastaras occurs thrice, we have to divide it by 3. So then we get 4 into 3 into 2, 1 into 2 into 3. So when we have 3 gurus, then we can replace one guru, one laghu with the guru. Then 4 occurrences of same pattern we see. Then we have to divide it by 4. Then we get number of occurrences of all gurus is simply 1. So we can see that the 4C4 here. So thus it is proved that the formula given by Bhaskara is proved. So he takes Ramachandra's words as they are, and he says thus it is proved. And next astronomer, mathematician he quotes is Vishnu Daivajna. So he is the son of Divakara, who resided in the Golak Grama on the banks of Godavari River. This name is mentioned in the context of quadrilateral while computing the diagonals of unequal quadrilateral. So this is the verse of Brahmagupta. Jatyadvayakoti bhujah parakarnahata bhujash chaturbhuje vishame adhiko bhurmukhamuno bahudvitayam bhujavanyav. So we can construct a cyclic quadrilateral by using two right angle triangles. So the same thing has been explained by Guru Tamair Vishnu Daivajnai. So he considers a great guru. Munisvara considers Vishnu Daivajna as his great guru. His verse is stated like this: Abhishta Karnodhruta Bhumukhe Staha Tatkoti Bahu Shravanastatascha Tadbhakta Bahu Bhujagoti Mane Karnaha Saeva Kila Jatya Yugmam. Let us see those triangles. So these are two right angle triangles we take. So NLM and RPQ. So by multiplying by the side of the other triangle, we get 4 similar triangles like this. So A2 is multiplied by, this triangle is obtained by multiplying all the sides by A2. So similarly, we get 4 right angle triangles. Jatya Tribhujas. And if we combine them, we get unequal quadrilateral, which happens to be cyclic actually. So though they do not mention explicitly that it is a cyclic one, so but it has the properties of cyclic one. So now Vishnu Daivajna says it reversely actually. So if we divide the Bhumi and Mukha by the Karna, if you will get the right angle triangle, so which we were supposed to construct first. So and then compute the we get B2 and A2, then you compute the C, which means the hypotenuse of the triangle. Then we divide these two bhujas, then you will get the sides of the other triangle. This is what Vishnu Daivajna says in this verse. Abhishta Karno Dhrata Bhumukhe. The Bhumi and Mukha are divided by a desired Karna. Then you get the Koti and Bahu of the triangle, and compute the Shravana, means the hypotenuse of the triangle, and divide the other two Bahus of the quadrilateral. Then you get Bhuja and Koti of the other triangle, and compute the Karna of that. So then another name we find in the commentary is Krishna Daivajna. So during the discussion on the mathematical operations of zero, he takes the Krishna Daivajna's words from the commentary on Bijaganita as it is. So here he says why by the multiplication by zero, why do we get zero, and by dividing by zero, why do we get the infinity. As multipliers increases, we get the maximum value for the product. As multiplier decreases, we get minimum. So when it decreases maximum, we should get zero. So as the divisor decreases to the maximum decrement means zero, then the quotient should increase maximum. So if you consider some amount for the quotient, then there will be paramatva vyaghata. So if you consider a number, we can get one more number which is more than the considered number. So we cannot consider any number for this kahara. So another mathematician's name we find is Surya. He is son of Jnanaraja. His place is Partha near Godavari, and he composed a text called Ganitamrata Kupika, which is a commentary on Lilavati, and he has composed some other works also. And here also the method of presenting is the arithmetic way of presentation. And here actually in the context of Trairashika, Pancharashika, he takes the he criticizes Surya Daivajna actually. So actually we did not fully understand what the contention is. So here he says, by saying what he says tadajnanam swasya prakatikritam. So Surya Daivajna has showed his ignorance by stating this. That is what Munisvara says. And we have to understand this, what the process. And in the context of geometric progression also, he criticizes, he rejects the idea of Surya Daivajna. And so we find other names like Narayana, Keshava Daivajna, and Balakrishna. So Narayana's name, he mentions by giving two of his examples, which is taken from Bijaganita of Narayana. So, but we don't know which Narayana he is. So both Narayanas precede this Munishwara. And Keshava Daivajna is quoted in the context of computation of chord. So not much is stated there. And in the in the context of varga prakriti also. And another name we find is Balakrishna. So a method to find out the area of Suchi Kshetra, as given by Balakrishna, is stated there. And as a conclusion, we can say that Nisrstarthaduti actually helps us to counter the allegations of lack of proofs in the Indian mathematics. And this text indicates the flow of the ideas between scholars, and as well as the existence of the an academic honor code regarding the attribution of ideas and concepts. And this text shines much light on the workings of the or thought process of the earlier mathematicians, and the means by which they try to convince themselves regarding the truth of mathematical statements. And thus the study of this commentary actually reiterates the importance of studying the commentaries of mathematical texts. So dhanyavadaha.